Hi, welcome to Real Time Signals Technologies. Today we are going to discuss about one more DevOps tool, container service called Docker. First of all, we have to understand the user concern of Docker. For example, assume there is a hotel consist of two bedrooms for two customers and there is only one kitchen. Then both users have share the same kitchen. This will lead to a problem for both users. To overcome this, the solution is creating a separate kitchens for each user. In the same way, if different applications are present in system, they have share the resources as their requirements. For example, in a system we have two applications. The first application require a Python version 2.7 and second application require Python version 3. But the system consists of Python 2.7 only. Then second application will fail to run. There are two solutions to overcome this problem. 1. You can install each application in a separate system, which generally cause more capital cost and very expensive. 2. Creating virtual machines. Here we can create VMs for each application on a single system. It will reduce cost. The second user concern is the general issue between a developer and a tester. First, developer develops an application and run it on his system environment. Then it will go to testing environment. Their application is unable to run on tester system. Then tester will raise an issue with developer and they start quarrel. This is because of the tester environment does not have the resources of that applications. To overcome it, we can put application with all its resources in box called container. Generally refers a Docker container. In general development and testing environment, developers and tester care about 1. Portable runtime environment. 2. Missing dependencies, packages. 3. Run tests faster. In production environment, system admins care about 1. Cost and performance. 2. Efficient, consistent and repeatable. 3. Speed, reliability of CD&C. Now we have dive into deep. First of all, we have to understand what is Docker. 1. Docker is a platform for developing, shipping and running applications using an open source container-based technology. Containers allow a developer to package up an application with all of the parts it needs, such as libraries and other dependencies, and ship it all out as one package. By doing so, thanks to the container, the developer can rest assured that the application will run on any other Linux machine regardless of any customized settings that machine might have that could differ from the machine used for writing and testing the code. 2. OS level virtualization. Operating system level virtualization is a great tool to create powerfully isolated multi-tenant environments. 3. Run everywhere, physical or virtual or cloud. The Docker standard way of build once run anywhere is by using a global Docker registry, e.g. Docker Hub, or an enterprise-wide Docker Trusted Registry, DTR. In this method, the built image resides in the registry and you can run the container anywhere where you have access to these Docker registries. 4. Run anything. If it can run on host, it can run in the container. Docker will run any type of applications collecting the resources from a container instead of host. Now we have to understand why only Docker. Because it deals with 1. Scalable lightweight. Container scalability is the trait where a container application can handle increased loads of work. This can be achieved by reconfiguring the existing architecture of a single machine to increase available resources or by provisioning additional containers within a cluster of distributed machines. 2. Portable. Docker apps can run anywhere. Portability means the ability to move an application, in other words, port it, from one host environment to another. In one sense, Docker containers offer a lot of portability. With containers, you can build an application once, place it inside a container image, or series of images, if the app is composed of multiple services, each running in a separate container, and run it on any host environment that supports Docker and runs on the same family of operating system. Practically speaking, this means that using Docker, you can host an application inside containers on Ubuntu Linux 16.04, then move that same application to a Red Hat Enterprise Linux 7.4 server without having to recompile anything. You simply move the container images over. 3. Docker allows to build any app in any language using any stack. 4. You don't have to pre-allocate any RAM, like in virtual machines. 5. Docker ensures your applications and resources are isolated and segregated. 6. Environment standardization and version control. Now let's dive a bit further. Virtualization versus containers. Virtual machines, VM, are managed by a hypervisor and utilize VM hardware, while container systems provide operating system services from the underlying host and isolate the applications using virtual memory hardware. However, it's possible to have a fixed set of applications in a single container. Now have a look on Docker images. In Docker, everything is based on images. An image is a combination of a file system and parameters. Let's take an example of the following. Docker image is made up of file systems layered over each other. A Docker base image is nothing but an OS user space minus the kernel. Base is a boot file system. Bootfs uses a union file system and root file system stays in read-only mode. Unionfs allows files and directories of separate file systems to be transparently overlaid, forming a single coherent file system. Basically a tar file. When a container is launched from an image, Docker mounts a read-write file system on top of any layers below. Docker components. The Docker contains two types of components. 1. Core components. Docker is a client-server application. It consists of the daemon that does the important job, builds and downloads images, starts and stops containers and so on. It exposes a REST API that specifies interfaces for interacting with a daemon and is being used for remote management. The Docker client is a command line program that is being used to manage Docker hosts running Linux containers. It communicates with the Docker server using the REST API wrapper. You will interact with Docker by using the client to send commands to the server. 2. Workflow components. A Docker image is a read-only blueprint containing information that will be used to create a Docker container. For example, you can create an image of a Linux operating system, your application and a web server. As a developer, you can create your own images or use images that have been developed by others. While a Docker image is a blueprint, a container is the running instance of the image. We can look at a container as a runtime object. Containers provide you with a lightweight and platform-independent way of running your applications. Containers can be started, stopped, moved or deleted via the command line interface or the Docker API. A Docker registry is a repository of images. Docker repositories can be public or private. Docker Hub, https://hub.docker.com, is a public registry where you can search and download images. Docker also gives you the capability to create your own Docker images, and it can be done with the help of Docker files. A Docker file is a simple text file with instructions on how to build your images. Let's get understand the Docker system. Container technology emerged from the Linux world, based on key features in the Linux kernel, including groups and namespaces. These features allow lightweight workloads to be virtualized within the Linux OS. This has become a popular way to build applications because of the speed and agility with which the applications can be built, tested, and deployed. Docker engineered its containers to be operated by means of a command line tool called the Docker client. This client may run on the container host, or through a remote interface connected to the container host. The principal job of a Docker client is to pull images of containers from a registry, which is a public or private repository of sources for ready-to-run virtual workloads. Docker Hub is the main public registry operated by Docker Incorporated, although there are now many others. Once the Docker daemon pulls a container image, It builds a working model for that container using a short batch of instructions, sometimes numbering as few as one. This build file may also include directives for the daemon to preload the container with other components prior to running, or directives to be given to the local command line once the local container image is built, thus necessitating the local, minimalized OS. Now to work with Docker, we need to install the Docker. If you have a system running with Windows, Docker for Windows is a Docker Community Edition, CE, app. The Docker for Windows install package includes everything you need to run Docker on a Windows system. Boot to Docker is a tiny VM which ships with http://boot2docker.io. VirtualBox. Docker Client. Installing Docker on CentOS. Follow these steps. Set up the Docker CE repository. Yum install yumutils. Yum config manager add repo https://download.docker.com/linux/centos/docker-c.repo. Installing the Docker package. Yum y install Docker CE. Starting the Docker daemon. Service start Docker or system cl start Docker. Now we have move our first steps towards the Docker by executing these commands. 1. Ensuring Docker is ready. By executing docker info command. 2. Docker run command. Docker run it ubuntu /bin/bash. I equals keeps tdn open from the container. T equals assigns a sudo t to the container. Then execute. Hostname. cat /etc/hosts. PSO. apt-get install vim. dpkgl vertical bar grep vim. Exit. 3. Container naming by executing docker run name adam underscore the underscore container it ubuntu /bin/bash command. 4. Starting a stopped container by docker start adam underscore the underscore container. 5. Attaching a container using docker attach adam underscore the underscore container. 6. Creating daemonized containers using docker run name adam underscore new d ubuntu /bin/shc while true, do echo hello world, sleep 1, done. 7. Fetch logs of a container using docker logs f adam underscore new. Also follow this commands. Stopping a container. Docker stop adam underscore new. List containers. Docker ps. A equals lists all containers. Q equals shows only container ID. Deleting a container. Docker rm adam underscore new. Inspecting the container's processes. Docker top adam underscore new. Docker inspect container ID. Docker inspect format.network settings.ip address container ID. Docker inspect format equals state.running container ID. Now let's dive a bit further. Run a command in a running container without attaching to it. Type and hit enter following commands. Docker exec container ID. Docker exec adam underscore new hostname. Docker exec dadm underscore new ls. To display a live stream of containers resource usage statistics. Docker stats, container IDs, apt-get update or apt-get install via Apache 2. To get real-time events from the server. Docker events filter, container vertical bar event vertical bar image vertical bar label vertical bar type vertical bar volume vertical bar network vertical bar daemon. Docker events filter event equals attach filter event equals die. Docker events since 1 hour. To exposing our container with port redirects. All ports are private by default. When you docker run pport, that port becomes public. When you docker run p, without port number, all ports declared with expose become public. Docker run p host port container port jinx latest. Docker run dp 8018 jinx latest. Now we have to understand data volumes in Docker. Volumes are the preferred way to persist data in Docker containers and services. Some use cases for volumes include sharing data among multiple running containers. If you don't explicitly create it, a volume is created the first time it is mounted into a container. A volume is a specially designated directory within one or more containers that bypasses the union file system. 1. Volumes can be shared and reused between containers. 2. A container doesn't have to be running to share its volumes. 3. Changes to a volume are made directly. 4. Changes to a volume will not be included when you update an image. 5. Volumes persist until no containers use them. To declare a volume from command line interface, CLI, run the following command. docker run /etv /usr/data/ubuntu. Sharing volumes across containers, data containers. This is done using the volumes from flag for docker run the commands. Docker run privileged equals true it volumes from test 1 Ubuntu. Docker run privileged equals true it volumes from test 1 volumes from test 2 Ubuntu. Here are some detailed data volume related commands which used in real time. To rename a container, run docker rename src dist. To show current available images, run docker images. To search for images, run docker search Ubuntu. To download images, run docker pull Debian Jesse. After understanding these topic, we have get deeper in docker system with interactively building images. The first step is to configure the files required for docker to build itself an image. Docker images are simply blueprints of environments that you want to create, while containers are the actual running and functional environments that your app will be executed in. To build images interactively, create a new container and make some changes. Docker run name adam_the_container_it_ubuntu. apt-get install vim. Exit inspect the changes. Docker diff adam_the_container. Commit and run your image. Docker commit adam_the_container. Docker commit adam_the_container my first image. Docker run it new imaged. Tagging images. Docker tag new imaged my first image. Create a test dir and a docker file. Mukadira test, cd test and vim docker file. From Ubuntu. Run apt-get y install vim. Build the image. Docker build t my first image. Running the build image. Docker run it my first image. List all the layers composing an image. Docker history my first image. Docker file instructions. The following are the docker file instructions which used in real scenario. Run. Run the command when the container is being built. Smd. Specifies the command to run when a container is launched. If values are specified during launch, it will override the docker file value. Smd. Echo. Hi. Docker build rmt equals adam/dockerfiles. Docker run it adam/dockerfiles. Entry point. Same as run, arguments we specify on the docker run command line will be passed as arguments to the command specified in the entry point. Entry point. Echo. Hi. Work dir. Provides a way to set the working directory for the container and the entry point and smd to be executed when a container is launched from the image. workdir/usr/bin. You can override the working directory at runtime with the w flag. Docker run it w/var/adam/dockerfiles. env. Set environment variables during the image build process. env oracle_home/var. User. Specifies a user that the image should be run as. User nobody. You can override this at runtime by specifying the u flag with docker run it u nobody adam/dockerfile. Volume. Data volumes. Volume/data. Copy. Adds files and directories from our build environment into our image. Copy readme/data1. This will add the readme file from the build dir to /data in the image. Add. Similar to copy, whereas it can extract archives. Add latest.tar.gz/var/www/wordpress. Maintainer tells you who wrote the docker file. Maintainer adam travis rts@gmail.com. Expose tells Docker what ports are to be published in this image. Expose 8080. Now it's time to set up Docker file on web server Apache. From Ubuntu colon 12.04. Maintainer Adam. Run apt-get update and apt-get install via Apache 2 and apt-get clean and /var/lib/apt/list/. env apache underscore run underscore user www data. env apache underscore run underscore group www data. env apache underscore log underscore /var/log/apache2. Expose 80. smd. /usr/sbin/apache2d. Foreground. Docker build t apache ingf. /dockerfile apache. Docker run dp8080v. /var/www/html:/var/www/html apache ing. This is the sample script to MongoDB in Docker environment. Follow the steps included in the script. That's it. Build the image using the new Docker file for MongoDB. Docker build t MongoDB image f. /dockerfile mongo. Docker run dp28001-27017 MongoDB image. Installing Jenkins with Docker. Docker run p8080-8080 name equals Jenkins master dnv java underscore opts equals xmx8192m Jenkins. Deleting images. Docker rmi adam /dockerfiles. Docker RMI Docker Images AQ. Finally, step of this Docker tutorial is deploying a registry server. To do this, run the following commands. Start your registry by Docker run dp5000-5000 restart equals always name registry registry colon 2. Tag a image in the registry by Docker tag Ubuntu localhost colon 5000/Ubuntu. Push image to registry by Docker push localhost colon 5000/Ubuntu. Pull image from registry by Docker pull localhost colon 5000/Ubuntu. Stop the registry by Docker stop registry. Docker RMV reg. For further information and training, contact. Call us 9740992552. Email info@realtimesig.com. For online and e-learning, please visit www.ibgeo.com. Martahalli Office. Real-Time Signals Technologies Private Limited. Number 102, Krishna Grand, over Martahalli Bridge, Bangalore, Karnataka, India 560037. BTM Office. Real-Time Signals Technologies Private Limited. Number 4, Second Floor, First Phase, Second Stage, BTM Layout, opposite to Udupi Garden, Bangalore 76, Bengaluru, Karnataka, 560076.